Okay, everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is, of course, another Pop Funko review, and as you can see, it is on another Disney one, and a yet another Belle POP. I got this Belle POP from my little Sunday outing last week with my best friends, and, you know, Belle is actually my second favorite Disney princess, so, and believe it or not, I have one more Belle POP to review after this, until I get more anyways. And I really do want to get all the Belle POPs. Of course, my first favorite princess being Snow White. I do really love Belle. So this Belle POP is a part of the recent... They've been out for a while, but they're still kind of new. Recent princess line that are all in dancing poses or in some kind of a pose. Most of them are in a dancing pose. And this Belle came out, and this actually gave people that are Funko fans, Beauty and the Beast fans, or even just Belle fans in general, a second chance to get a yellow dress Belle. Back in 2011 in Series 2, there was a yellow dress Belle, and I do just kind of want to compare boxes really fast. And, of course, you know, when POPs come out, they're very easy to find. But once they go retired, and Disney POPs are probably the worst that go retired at them. They're probably the ones that go retired the most out of any POP line are the Disney ones. So, when they go retired, they're impossible to get. And so, I started collecting POPs around 2014, maybe late 2013, and Belle, of course, this Belle was, of course, easy to find still, or easy to get, and, of course, I wanted a Belle for my collection, and at the time, that was the only Belle. This one, and then the nerdy one. To be honest, I do want all the Belles from the live action, from the cartoon, but the nerdy one, which was on the same body as the original Belle, this Belle, actually, but it had glasses on. I never really understood those ones. Why? I think they were from some memes or something. So anyway, so I was able to get Belle and the Beast, the original Beast, in a set on eBay for $23. And actually, not that long ago, I just realized she was retired. And then she went retired, and that gave. That really upset some people that wanted a yellow dress Belle. And I'm going to move this box. We're going to compare them in a minute. So this gave them a second chance to get a yellow dress Belle. So really fast, before we actually take a look at the new box, I just want to compare them really. There's the images right there. There's the sides right there. And you can see they're very different Belles. And then there's the back right there. And, you know, I really don't like it because what they'll do is Funko will go through, especially the Disney line, and pick out POPs to retire. Like, as Belle, if you go on Pop Price Guy, which is the official pricing for POPs, she's listed for $115. You can't buy them on there. POP just tells you how much they go for, and Beast is still $11. I hate when they do that. If they're going to retire one, they should just retire them all, in my opinion, instead of, you know, just retiring a few. Because before this Belle was out, you only could get the Nerdy Belle to go with Ballroom Beast. So there's that, and then there's the top, and then there's the side. So I just wanted to show you that box really fast. So now we can actually get into the new box. And of course it's a standard Pop Funko box. We got the Pop logo there, Disney logo, 221, the image right there, Belle, there's the top, there's the side, the other side. Now unfortunately, I actually saw all of these POPs in the line when I was out Sunday, But I only saw one of Belle. And unfortunately, it's not too bad, but unfortunately her box is a little damaged. She was at FYE. She was right in the front. So I had a feeling, I have a feeling that people were picking her up and someone dropped her. And but I've really been wanting this Belle for a long time now. So, I didn't want to miss a chance to get her. So I'm going to go ahead and open, since I don't want to ruin the top, I opened from the bottom. Now it's just easier that way. And so let's get her open. And as you can see, she is already a gorgeous pop. And I'm really, of course, she has the swirl on the head. And I'm really loving her. If you can see all the detail on her dress is very nice. You can see her ribbons going around, all the wrinkles and folds going around in her dress. You can see where she's holding it. You can see her under dress right there. Someone dropped something outside. And you can see all that detail right there. You can see her top right there. And of course, you can see her hands, and she's wearing gloves. Of course, she is in the dancing pose. Of course, her face, she does have eyebrows. She does have earrings. And her hair is really, really pretty, too. As you can see, it's wavy, as if she were dancing. And you can see her bun and her yellow band right there. She does have earrings. I'm not sure if I said that. And then, of course, you see the date on there. I do want to just say, if your pop doesn't have the date on it, that most likely means it's fake. So always make sure you have the date and Funko logo on it. And this Belle actually makes a great pair with the Beast. So if you missed out on the original Belle here, you have another chance to get her. And honestly, she looks a lot better with the Beast. Even though the Beast isn't in a dancing pose, she just looks so much better with him. So yeah, so I hope they do. Maybe they did just come out with another Beast, which I do have to review for you guys, but I hope they do a dancing pose Beast. So here's the original Belle, of course, and as you can see, the differences are just, you know, they're in the same outfit. You can see the new one's head is a little bigger. Their hair is a little different. Obviously, the old one doesn't have eyebrows. She's not wearing earrings. And she's... A lot of the old Princess Pops, like Snow White, Cinderella, actually are all in the same pose. They use the same body mold, just different paint. And, of course, they added the ribbons on Belle's dress. I'm very happy to have both of them in my collection. I know some Beauty and the Beast fans, you know, as much as they're happy to have this one, they still do want this one. And I feel so bad that she's retired for them, but what can you do? You know, people, you know, even though they can't have this one, they can have finally a yellow dress one. And of course, the yellow dress ones for Emma Watson's Belle are coming out as well, or they're out. But I always hope that they put out Funkos like this again to give people another chance. Because, you know, I have a couple friends that are Beauty and the Beast fans, and they're like, yeah, I'm really glad I have the new one, but I still really need, you know, because some people are completist and they want all the Beauty and the Beast ones. I'm the same way with like Snow White. I'm so mad that I can never have the San Diego Comic-Con Regina pop. And I need her because she's the evil queen, and I need all the evil queen pops. So, I know how that feeling goes, and I was very lucky to be able to get the original Belle. But honestly, the new one is so much better. It's so much more prettier, better, and a lot more gorgeous and detailed. I mean, this is when pops were just kind of basic, not a whole lot of detail. At the time, this was really nice, you know. But, of course, the new one takes the cake. So, unfortunately, as you can see, there is a little scuff right there. But, again, this was the only one I saw that day. And I really, really wanted this Belle. So, I'm just going to move that one. So, if you don't have her, I definitely recommend her. for you. Are you going to be picking up any of these princesses? We have Ariel, Belle, Cinderella, Rapunzel, and Tiana. I do want to get Ariel and Cinderella because I already have the other ones, especially Ariel. I already have the mermaid one and the blue dress one. I have the original Cinderella and the live-action Cinderella too. Even though I don't like that Cinderella because it's of her reimagined look and that Disney did, and I really don't like that. I like the classic look. So let me know if you have or are going to get any, or you're just going to pass on them altogether. I definitely do recommend this Belle. She's beautiful. I love the detail on her. I love that she's holding her dress up and you can see her under dress or bosset. I forget what it's called, but and it's her hair is beautiful as well. So that is going to do it for this review. In today's review, we were looking at the Pop Funko Belle in the new Disney line, Dancing Poseidon. And if you see her out, get her, because she is a really pretty pop. And I will be back with another Batman animated series review, probably tomorrow. That's going to be it for this video. If you have any questions, as always, feel free to ask me in the comments below. And please subscribe to my channel. And as always, my information is down below. As always, thank you for watching and have a great day. Bye. Okay, you guys made it to the end of the video. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Remember, you guys can follow me on the social media links I have in my channel and down below. And I also do have a fan mail address. If you would like to send fan mail, feel free to do so. And I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Please subscribe to my channel and have a great day. Bye.